Well, new details are emerging about plans to put suicide barricades on the Coronado Bridge by the end of the month.
Our 10 News reporter Travis Rise spoke to a bridge jump survivor who led the push for those barriers and calls them a critical step to a permanent solution.
I would have lost and missed so much over the last 31 years.
Stephen Bouchard loves the time he's had despite almost losing it all from one hasty decision.
Drove the center span to watch for the crown of the bridge. I parked right in the center, bolted to the edge, looked over the edge, and just threw my feet over. That fast. That's it.
Bouchard is among a handful of people who have survived the 200-foot leap from the Coronado Bridge.
I just got tunnel vision. That's all I wanted to do. I didn't care about anything else.
Which is why he's looking forward to Caltrans installing bird spikes along the 2-mile-long span in coming weeks.
It gives an opportunity for somebody, if they do pause, that someone could come up behind them and stop them from doing so.
420 people have jumped to their death since the bridge opened 50 years ago. Engineers believe the same spikes seen on roofs and ledges will deter people from climbing over.
So obviously the spikes are going up soon, but is it still the end goal to have a larger barricade for you guys?
Yes. We'd like to see, there are a number of designs out that Caltrans are checking out.
For this survivor, every moment matters.
All it takes is seconds to pull somebody back.
Travis Rice, 10 News.
Caltrans says the bird spike measure is temporary and a permanent barrier is still being pursued.